I'm Cory Wilkins, Western Regional Director of the Archaeological Conservancy. We are here at our Hamilton Family Archaeological Preserve in Northern Nevada on Lake Lahontan.
We are on the ancestral lands of the Numu or the Northern Paiute, which is the ethnographic affiliated with the Fallon Paiute Shoshone tribe in Fallon. This preserve is a collection of 72 rock depressions in a volcanic talus slope. These depressions are dug into the slope and then stacked around the downward side and excavated out from the hillside to create these multiple impressions along this hillside. These rocks are from volcanic activity in the area. They've probably been here a long time. And as they've been here, they develop a patina or a certain shine on them. And that lets us know that this side of the hill, the depressions are older than on the other side of the hill, because on the other side, some of the rocks have not developed a patina on all of the sides around the rocks. Behind me is the Lahontan Reservoir. In Pleistocene times, there used to be a Pleistocene Lake Lahontan that filled up a large part of Nevada. And as you can see, there are, in the talus slope in the hill behind us, there are striations marking how high that lake was in the Pleistocene era. This is the Carson River behind me, and it has been dammed downstream from this. It's the damming of the Carson River. And it's also surrounded by the Lahontan State Recreation Area. So there are people who like to boat on the lake, and they like to camp along it and do some backcountry driving in the area. But throughout the state rec area, there are also private parcels. And this is one of them with this unique site that we have acquired.
This acquisition was brought about by the Hamilton family, actually. They were doing a lot split. They've been protecting this site for quite some time, ever since they purchased the property decades ago. They knew that this was worth protecting, and they had done it as a family. What they wanted to do was split off the rest of the property to sell it off for housing or development or whatever, but they still wanted to maintain preservation of this site. So when they went in to do the lot split, they contacted Churchill County, who in turn contacted the SHPO in Nevada, who in turn got us involved. So I met Mrs. Hamilton and the planner for Churchill County out here, and we took a look around and threw around some ideas. And not being an archaeologist, I knew that this was a man-made site, something ancient, but I had no idea what it was. So what I did is I brought out, I didn't have a field representative at the time, so I brought out Greg White from California. And we walked through once, documented all the features. We documented 76 separate features. Threw around some more ideas and left with more questions than answers. So we came back out to look for associated artifacts to see if we could get anything diagnostic on the site. And again, found nothing. Did a little bit more documentation. We looked all around the site for some things and didn't find anything. We did determine that the site was worth preservation, so I took it to the board of directors, and after a lot of discussion, we decided to acquire the site. So in 2022, we purchased this 22-acre site from the Hamilton family and named it after them because of their efforts to preserve it in the past.
The Hamilton Family Archaeological Preserve is in excellent condition and shows no signs of looting or damage. The leading theory is that it may have served as a vision quest site, but this has not yet been confirmed with research.